Selection sorts are different from bubble sorts because they make several passes through the entire list.
On the first pass, it identifies the smallest or largest item in the list and moves it to the front of the array.
On each consecutive pass, it identifies the next smallest or largest item among those remaining and places it to the previously sorted one.
This process repeats until every item has been sorted accordingly.
So here we have a group of adolescent human beings in their natural habitat.
Fortunately, these ignorant creatures have no idea that we're there, so we're going to do a little experiment on them.
So as you can see, human beings come in many different sizes. So today, we are going to sort them from shortest to tallest by using a selection sort.
So, from this first pass, I've determined that this is the shortest human in the list. So, as such, I should move him to the front of the line.
So now I shall make another pass to search for the next shortest person in the group and move them to the appropriate position.
So from this next pass, I've determined this to be the next shortest human in the group. So, as such, I shall move her to the appropriate position.
So now there are only two people left to sort, so this is the last pass. As you'll notice, this means that a selection sort passes through a list one time less than the number of items in that list.
This next pass, I've determined this to be the next shortest human in the group, so we'll move her to the appropriate position.
So now that there's only one person left in this list, we know that they must be the tallest person in that list, so we don't have to bother making another pass. And that's all, folks!